Every year, DISTA celebrates Culture Week in style. The week of 22nd to 26th of March 2010 marked the Culture Week on DISTA Earth River campus, with Friday 26th marking the climax of this event. Friday was the Culture Week gala night, and this night was truly a night to remember. Various cultural groups on campus showcased the very best of their traditions. They dressed up, they had artifacts representing their cultures, they had food, and they had dances from these different communities. The mouth-watering dishes quickly grabbed my attention. At 6 p.m. on this memorable day, I began a journey of the proud display of culture on the campus provincial administration court. As the various groups began to bring in their mouth-watering meals, I began my journey. The Kalenjin started it first. Of course, they had the morsik, a must-be on their menus for food. They also had meat, porridge, and traditional vegetables. I went onto the Costerian corner. Oh my, how palatable their food was, well designed. And they were all dressed up, behaving so Costerian. Then came in the Kisii, the Banana Republic of Kenya, all very proud of themselves, displaying the various towns and the communities back home. They were all smiles. And then there were the Luya, oh yes, and Koko, and all that. Visibly present on their table was live and even palatable chicken. How they were so proud of their culture and heritage. The sons and daughters of Mumbi and Gikuyu could not miss out on the show either. They had to represent their culture and the peoples, and they did it just right. Towards sunset, I followed the party on, and there were the Meru with the various tuber goods they wonderfully displayed, with calabashes of drinks besides. More food kept streaming in from the kitchen, and I also kept moving on my journey. Directly opposite the Meru, the Embu, one of Kenya's food baskets, so they say, gave their all to the event and attested to this claim that they are truly the food basket of Kenya. And then the well-represented and so organized Maasai, oh, they did their thing as usual, they did it well. They were all dressed up for the occasion, they acted it and got everyone in love with them. No wonder the judges of the day began their judgment from their table. They seemed not to want to leave the table anyway, and they were always nodding and smiling at the people who were serving them. The Maasai were visibly brilliant in their attire, and they were so in love with themselves. Well, I was not so surprised that all the students whose communities were not represented were not left out either, because they found themselves a place in the Maasai community. Surprise, surprise, there were first-timers on the show. The Watoto wa Congo, yes, the people from Democratic Republic of Congo. These students decided to find a time to represent their country and their people. They cooked, they dressed, they danced, and they had bigger plans for the gala night to come ahead. Another newcomer on the list was Uganda, the Pearl of Africa. They couldn't miss out on this year's Culture Week either. The children of the Kabaka and Nabagereka of Buganda were so happy with themselves, and of course, the fact that they are the lovers of bananas was so evident on their table. This was only the beginning of the Culture Week 2010 Gala Night. Well, if this was the beginning of this Gala Night, all merrymaking and joy, how could the end of this night have been then? Watch out for part 2 of Culture Week Gala Night, the Le Grand Finale 2010.